Next comes to subaerial modifications of stem. In subaerial modifications, the stem is partly aerial and partly underground. Short aerial branches and adventitious roots develop at the nodes. Detachment of entire branch or a node can develop into a new plant. These plants are commonly known as creepers, and they are subaerial stem modifications meant for vegetative propagations or reproduction. So let's see some subaerial modifications of stem. The first is runners. In case of runner, the plant is very small. Some part of stem is aerial, some part is below the ground. From the stem, on the lower side, roots arise. These are the adventitious roots, and the upper side would arise leaves. So the runners in the stem gives rise to a branch which run parallel to the ground, and this branch is also with nodes and internodes. Whenever the nodes comes in contact with proper soil, it is going to give rise to a small stem in which some part is above the ground and some is below the ground, and that stem also gives rise to branch, and this branch also have nodes and internodes, and nodes comes in contact with soil and again it gives rise to another stem. So it appears as if the plant is taking steps and moving in a direction. That's why this modification is called runners. So the connection between these is pretty much strong. If you try to pull this plant, other 2-3 plants are also pulled along with it. For example, cyanodon, that is dub grass, and oxalis, etc. Next comes to another similar type of modification, that is offset. Offset is aquatic, so the plant grows on the surface of water. Here the stem is swollen because it has parenchyma which helps the plant to float. From this stem would arise a transverse branch. The branch is also swollen and the branch arises in all directions. The branches is normally one internode long. So the leaves arise from this stem, produce a rosette of leaves above and adventitious root below. For example, pistia, icornia, etc. So the difference between runners and offset are, the runners is terrestrial while the offset is aquatic. The connecting branch in case of runners is long and with multiple nodes and internodes, while in case of offset there is soft, swollen and one internode long. The branches in case of runner arises normally in one direction. In case of offset, the branches arises in all the directions. Next comes to another modification, sucker. Here the stem is small. Some part of stem is underground, some part of stem is above the ground. From the underground part of the stem, the branches arise from the nodes. So the branch grows horizontally for a distance under the soil and then move obliquely upward and give rise to another stem. This branch is also stem and has nodes and internodes. Adventitious root arise from this vertical stem, and above the soil there is regular leaves and plant. So this underground connecting transverse branch is known as sucker. So when we see all these plant, we do not see any connection between them, because this transverse connection which is there is not visible above the ground as it was visible in case of the runners. For example, chrysanthemum, musa, mentha, pineapple, etc. Next comes to another similar type of modification, stolon. Here also the plant has small stem, some part is underground, some part is above the ground. The lateral branch arises again the underground part of the stem. It grows above the ground and obliquely touches the ground. This lateral branch has nodes and internodes, and when the node comes in contact with the soil, it again gives rise to stem. Again from the underground stem would arise a branch. It goes aerial and again touches the ground, then gives rise to stem. Same thing here also, adventitious root from the base of the stem and upper parts have plant leaves, branches, etc. For example, colocasia, strawberry, vallisneria, etc. So the difference between suckers and stolon is that transverse connection. In case of sucker, the transverse connection remains underground. In case of stolon, it remains above the ground. So I don't see any connections in suckers because it is underground. In stolon, we distinctly see the loop-like connections between the plants. Next comes to aerial modifications of stem. In certain plants, the aerial stem or buds get modified to perform special functions like climbing, protection, food storage, vegetative propagation, etc. In this, the real stem gets so much modified that it is difficult to identify it as a stem. So, various type of aerial modifications are as follows. First comes to stem tendrils. The stem or its branches get modified into green thread-like leafless structures called tendrils, which are meant for climbing. These may be branched or unbranched. A scaly leaf is always present at the point of branching of the tendrils. So the stem tendrils are of various types. Axillary tendrils, for example, passiflora. Here the axillary buds modified into tendril. Extra axillary tendril, for example, cucurbita and lupa. Leaf opposed or apical bud tendril, for example, grapevine. Here the apical bud or terminal bud modified into tendrils for the support of the plant. Next, floral bud or inflorescence tendril, for example, antigonan. Next comes to another modification, thorns. These are straight, pointed, hard or woody structures. Sometimes they bear leaves, flowers or even maybe branched. It is present in the axil of leaf or apex of stem. These are modified stem performing the functions of either climbing or defense, and it also check transpiration. In citrus and duranta, thorns are modified axillary buds. In case of bougainvillea, the thorns are modified extra axillary buds. Next comes to another modification, phylloclades. Phylloclades are fleshy, green flattened or cylindrical branches of unlimited growth. The leaves are modified into spines or scales to check transpiration. They take part in photosynthesis and store water. These are seen in xerophytic plant like opuntia, euphorbia, casuarina, cactus, etc. In opuntia, the stem is modified into green, thick, fleshy part which perform photosynthesis. That means the stem has taken over the function of leaves because the leaves are modified into spines. So the spines are modified leaves, and we know leaves are arise from nodes. So every point where these spines are arise, this is actually nodes. So we can say that the phylloclades is a thick fleshy stem with many nodes and internodes, and we also see some part attached to the parent part. another modification is cladodes or cladophiles. So cladodes are green cylindrical or flattened leaf-like branch of limited growth. They help in photosynthesis. These are only one internode long. For example, asparagus, roscus, etc. Here, the main stem bears branches. On the branch are present scaly leaves, and from the axil of scaly leaves arises another branch, and this branch has become thick, fleshy and green. So these are one internode long, thick and fleshy. So these are modified stem. Next is bulbil. Bulbil is a special type of multicellular structure and functions as an organo-vegetative reproduction. It is modified from either a vegetative bird or flower bird. It gets swollen because of accumulation of food. After being detached from the parent plant, it falls on the surface of soil and gives rise to new plant under suitable conditions. For example, Dioscorea bulbifera. In Dioscorea, bulbils is an axillary structure. In Oxalis, bulbils are found are at the apex of tuberous roots. In onion and agave, bulbils are found on inflorescence and are modified flowers. So these are the aerial modifications of the stem, in which the stem is modified into tendril for helps the plant to climb up or to support. In thorn, the main function is protection. In phylloclade, the modification is for storage of food and water and performing photosynthesis. In cladode, main function is photosynthesis as the stem is green. In bulbil, the stem is modified for storage of food and reproduction. So this was all about stem, various forms of stems and modification of the stem. Next we will discuss about leaves. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for more updates. Thank you.